That being said, one of the problem, if you keenly observe with SCP is, even though files already exist, it is copying all the files every time. So let me show here. Let me use this one where we are trying to copy to Mesos 005. Irrespective of the files exist, it will again and again copy the same files into the target directory, which is not good. If the file sizes are big, then there is no point in copying everything onto the remote machine. That's where rsync comes into picture. You should be more familiar with rsync. Rsync provides you a lot more capabilities than SCP, and it works almost the same way for the first time. But from the second time, it will only sync the files if there is a difference between your source files and the target files. Let us see it in action. Now I am logging into Mesos 5. And I am deleting this. And if you want to get some reference for rsync, you can say --help, and you can see all these different properties which are available to you. You can see with rsync, you can exclude a particular directory, you can exclude all the directories or files which are mentioned in exclude from. You can say, you can either give a pattern, and you can also pass a file using which the stuff needs to be ignored while doing rsync. You can compress while copying, hence performance will be better. It will not compress the actual files while saving, but in the transit while copying files from your machine into these remote machines, in between while it is going through the network, the data will be compressed for you if you use rsync. With SCP, it will not be done. And the control argument to compress is Z. We use Z quite frequently while using rsync. And then you can skip the files that are already copied based on several properties. If you want to consider only size but ignore other things while copying the files, we can say --size only. The relevance of that is, let's say your timestamps are different between your source data and the target data. In that case, if you just run without this size only, it will again try to copy because the timestamps differ. Instead of copying based on just timestamp, if you want to consider the size to say that the files are different between source and target, then you can say size only. Only those files that match in size will be skipped, others will be copied. Like that, there are many arguments, but the most frequent arguments which we'll be using is -a, where it will create an archive while copying and then it will copy the files. You don't need to use -r because by default rsync try to do it recursively, so there is no need to use recursive. If you want to maintain the relative paths, you can use -R for that. Again, it is the default behavior, you don't need to worry too much about it. And if you want to preserve certain properties, if you want to only preserve owner while copying, you can say -o. If you want to preserve only group, you can say -g, or you can say both if you want to preserve both. By default, it will be preserving whatever is there on source, but if you want to preserve only certain things, you can control that by passing these arguments, and we don't use these things that often. Apart from -a, quite often we'll be using z so that we actually compress the data while copying. Now let us see it in action. You can say rsync -avz so that it will run in verbose mode, and we will see the output here. Also, we typically use h. Let us see what is h here. Not capital H but small h. I'm just going through the list to see the recommendation for the reference for H, human readable. So if you want to see the output in human readable format, you can use H also. Otherwise, it will just give the byte level information. So I can say rsync -avzh, and I want to sync data into this location, into the home directory. You can see here, it is copying all these things into the target system. It is a bit slower than what we have seen with SCP for the first time, but if I run once again, as there are no files which differ in size or which differ in timestamp, it did not copy even a single file. If you have to copy on a regular basis, and if you want to find the difference between the source and target, and if you want to only copy the delta, then rsync comes very, very handy. I recommend you to explore rsync as much as you can, and you should be using it rather than SCP. That being said, Now let us modify one file just to make sure that at least one file will be copied if it is modified. I'm going into the data directory here. Now let us go to NYSC. And now let me just say touch. I'm just updating the timestamp for this. Now I'm going to home directory and I'm running rsync once again. You can see that only that file is copied. Even though size matches, so the way it will compare between source and target to find the delta is, it will check for the owner name, group name, probably permissions, file size, timestamp. It actually preserves the timestamp both in the target from the source. It will also check whether the timestamps match. And then it will determine the delta based on all these criteria and it will copy by default. If you want to just, let me go to data NYSC once again. And now let us say touch once again. So the timestamp is modified on the source and it has a different timestamp on the target. If you want to ignore all other criteria, you can use skip size only argument and it will skip all the other criteria while determining the delta and it will only use the size as the criteria. So you can say rsync hyphen avgh and then hyphen hyphen size only. Now it did not copy. So these are the cool features which you should be aware of. I will not be covering all the combinations of rsync, but I have given some examples which we have to use quite frequently. Now let us understand where we have to use this. Typically, when it comes to an organization, there will be different types of environments. What are those environments? There will be production. Let me put in red. We have to be extremely careful while doing anything in production. And then there can be testing. Here also you have to be careful, but not as much as in production. That's why I'm highlighting them in yellow or orange. UAT, performance, like that. And then you will have development environments. This can be typical playground. They are also sensitive, but not as sensitive as others. Most of the times, what we'll do is we will actually take the backups of the existing databases in production and we want to copy it to the lower environments to replicate either a functional issue or performance issue. In that case, the database servers are quite big and the backup has to be restored on the lower level environments, and there we have to copy the files, and sometimes we have to do it quite regularly. And also, if you are getting data into production, into the file servers, and if the data is being processed, if you are a data engineer, the data might be coming into production in the form of flat files. And the size of those flat files are also typically big. And if you have to copy those things to the lower environments to reproduce a bug or to test your performance so that the size of the files are a bit more realistic than whatever we create by cooking up some data, in that case also we have to copy the files from production to the lower environments, and we might have to do it regularly also. So in all those scenarios, we have to use these commands like scp or rsync rather than using tools like WinSCP, and especially for the lateral use case where at least once in a week we copy couple of days worth of data to the lower environment like performance to validate our jobs before deploying in production. You need to automate the process and you have to schedule it. So you need to have fair understanding about this rsync command. And then you should be able to develop shell scripts and you should be able to schedule them so that we get whatever we need from the production to performance. So when the scripting comes handy, for example, if the data have social security number or Aadhaar card number, you should be masking that information while copying into the lower environments. You should not be copying directly from production to UAT or performance. Instead, you have to mask them. As part of the automation, shell scripting, you will be masking the data and will be creating new set of files, and probably you might have to perform the rsync. So these are the type of things which we'll do for copying the files between the environments. Again, it all depends upon the role you are playing. If you are a database administrator, typically you take the backups of the databases from the production and then you scp to the lower environments and you will take it from there. Very, very important command. Make sure you spend enough time on rsync be as comfortable as possible.